Well, one of these gotta go, but should I keep the M4 MacBook Air or my M3 Pro MacBook Pro? Let's find out. I've spent the last week with the new M4 MacBook Air running it through tests and workflows that I've typically done on my M3 Pro MacBook Pro. I tested battery life, see what accessories I need to make up for the port difference, is it really that much thinner and lighter, and seen all the shades of sky blue and space black. Alright, let's talk about design first. Obviously the MacBook Air is thinner and lighter, but I was surprised at how much lighter it actually feels. You can see it's also thinner, and while it's a 13-inch screen, and we'll get to display in a second, it also has a smaller footprint than the 14-inch MacBook Pro. Also, if you look at the specs page on Apple, we are talking about an almost full pound difference, 3.5 pounds for the MacBook Pro, 2.7 pounds for the new MacBook Air. Now, when it comes to ports, you get the two Thunderbolt ports on the MacBook Air, but of course on the MacBook Pro, you get the HDMI and SD card slot. I do sometimes miss the USB-C port on the opposite side for the Air just for charging, but not a huge deal. Now, I've been using my Osmo Pocket 3 to do a lot of filming, so I've actually found I don't need an SD card reader as much anymore. But for those times I might need an HDMI port or an SD card reader, I got this Anker 8-in-2, I think. I'll link to this down in the video description, but it's got HDMI, Thunderbolt, and the two SD card readers, plus some USB-A ports. And I like these two port style hubs because they actually fit nicely and stay pretty secure on the edge of the laptop. And it also doesn't block the MagSafe charger, which is key. We'll get to performance in a second too, but I also have to be honest with myself, I really only use my laptop when traveling or doing light admin work out on the patio. I have a Mac Studio for all my main video editing needs. I'll do transcription from audio files. I do my compressor exports. Basically, I have my Mac Studio to be the heavy computer, so maybe I can take a light computer wherever I go. Which I am glad I went with the 13-inch MacBook Air. If you're gonna get a small and light computer to be small and light, get the small and light version. And whenever I had gotten a larger size laptop like a 16-inch MacBook Pro, I always regretted it and went back to the smaller size. So I like the 13-inch size, and when it comes to the color, I did go with sky blue. It really does look silver in many lighting conditions, but you got that light blue haze, and I'm down for it. Especially outside, and depending on the lighting, sometimes it looks really blue. One little detail I missed though, it does have MacBook Pro etched into the bottom of the MacBook Pro. No etching on the MacBook Air. I don't know if it's too thin for that, or that's a Pro feature, but I do kind of like that little etching. So let's talk about display. If performance isn't the biggest caveat to the MacBook Air, it's definitely the display. The M3 MacBook Pro and M4 have the XDR display. ProMotion, so it goes up to 120 Hz refresh rate. It also just has more pixels. It does get brighter, up to 1000 nits sustained full screen, where the MacBook Air is only 500. Although for SDR content, the MacBook Pro is at 600, so not a huge difference there. They both have wide color and true tone, and then of course the ProMotion on the MacBook Pro. I'll be honest, I am picky about displays most of the time. That's why I have an M4 iPad Pro. But that also means if I want to look at the best screen Apple makes, it's actually the Tandem OLED on that iPad Pro. That's where I edit the audio version of my podcast, Primary Technology with me and Jason A10. Totally subscribe, link above. And I did find when I'm comparing these side by side, if I'm looking at the MacBook Air right next to the MacBook Pro, obviously you see a difference. Colors are richer, contrast is better, and of course the ProMotion. But you're never really going to be comparing them side by side in your home or where you're working. And I found when I was just using the MacBook Air, whether it was to edit video or to do some messaging, the display was fine. Even using it outside, of course in direct sunlight, it's going to be hard to see. That's true with the MacBook Pro as well, unless you get the nano texture, so it doesn't feel like a huge downgrade to me. And overall, using the MacBook Air for the past week, the display differences didn't bother me. Also, while I've been carrying the MacBook Air around, I've been using Waterfield's Pro Executive Sleeve. They didn't sponsor, and I don't even get affiliate revenue if you buy one, so I only mention because I love their sleeves. This one, you can actually have your MacBook Air on this side, and you could do like an iPad Pro on this side. Pockets here for things like the USB-C hub, and then this front pocket has their trademark orange inside where you throw your cables. I have my chargers, which I've actually been using this Nomad 65-watt slim charger. And I'm going to be doing a whole accessory video for the MacBook Air, so get subscribed because that's coming soon. But I also picked up this UGREEN 65-watt charger. This one has two USB-C and a USB-A port. And I'm going to compare this to the Nomad and see how this does with the MacBook Air. But now comes the true test, which is performance. I do video editing and Final Cut. I'll usually have multiple 4K video files in a multicam sequence, so I brought one of my projects that I edited on my Mac Studio over with the external SSD to this MacBook Air. And I'll say, editing that video, it didn't miss a beat. I even compared the export time with compressor directly with the M3 MacBook Pro, and surprisingly, the M4 Air actually won out on that export. Now, I was doing some other tasks as well. I was actually transcribing an audio file using Transcriptionist. That's my favorite app for transcribing on the Mac. I'll link that one below as well. And also opened a big Pixelmator file, and using Pixelmator Super Resolution, I made it 10,000 pixels wide. Interestingly in that, the M3 Pro MacBook Pro actually did the Pixelmator adjustments first, and it was happening at the same time as my compressor export, and then the M4 Air one compressor. So basically, in my use cases, which is exporting videos, transcribing, doing Pixelmator for a thumbnail, these are pretty on par, and I don't think I'm gonna be losing much performance with the Air over the Pro. Now, there was one time where I was editing a video, I was on battery power, it wasn't plugged in, and I tried the same thing. I was exporting a video using compressor, transcribing with Transcriptionist, had Pixelmator open working on a thumbnail, and I was also trying to edit a second video in Final Cut. And doing all that on battery on the Air, it did start to choke. Now that's something I do on my Mac Studio all the time and doesn't miss a beat. It never slows down, can still do all the exporting behind the scenes, and so obviously I reached a bottleneck, which of course, it's an M4, not a Pro or a Max. But if you plug in a power and you drop like one of those tasks, maybe transcribing or the thumbnail work, then you should be just fine with the M4 MacBook Air. And if you're not doing 8K and you're not doing 6 or 7 4K video streams, editing in Final Cut on this, and I do that off an external SSD. I edited multiple projects. I'm actually editing this video right now on this M4 MacBook Air, and it's doing just fine. One little disappointment, the M4 MacBook Air doesn't have Wi-Fi 7. They kept it going with Wi-Fi 6E. Now I was still able to get 700 megabits down on my Wi-Fi and over a gig upload speeds, so it's not a huge deal, but for a brand new M4 MacBook Air in 2025, would have been nice to have Wi-Fi 7. Now, one little detail I don't hear very much in relation to the new MacBook Air and even the M4 MacBook Pros. The keyboard on this computer is better. It is better than the M3 versions of the Air and MacBook Pros before it. It's a little clickier, keys feel a little firmer, and when you type side by side with this and my M3 Pro MacBook Pro, the M3 feels like squishy and not as nice to type on. Apple didn't say anything about the keyboard, and there's been no audible improvements that Apple has said it made on this MacBook Air, but for whatever reason, typing on the M4 MacBook Air, and my co-host on Primary Tech, Jason Aten, says it's like this on the M4 MacBook Pros as well, it's just nicer. Typing is better. They did something to the keyboard behind the scenes. Because of that, I prefer the M4 Air over the Pro when it comes to writing. I also find the M4 MacBook Air battery life to be a little better than the M3 Pro. Obviously not when doing the big tasks like editing and compressor, but I found on standby, just leaving the MacBook Air sitting for a day or two, it held onto battery better than my MacBook Pro. And that's a big deal. I found a lot of Apple devices drain quickly when they're just in standby. I found this to have better standby time and just battery life if you're doing tasks like emailing, web browsing. If you're doing stuff like that, battery life is going to be amazing. You're going to last all day, maybe even into the next. And of course, if you get a 65-watt charger or higher, you can fast charge the Air using the MagSafe cable that it came with. So which am I gonna keep and which am I gonna trade in? Well, the M3 Pro MacBook Pro, I bought it when it first came out and I didn't spec it up very much. 16 gigs of unified memory, 1 terabyte SSD, and I do like it. The space black is nice, it served me well, but I was able to get a $1,000 trade-in on this and a spec'd out MacBook Air, I got it with 2 terabyte SSD, 32 gigs of unified memory, and it's about $2,100. So for $1,000, I'm gonna trade in my old MacBook Pro, keep the M4 MacBook Air, the performance on the road or when I have to edit when traveling, I think it's gonna be just fine. The display, I see the difference when it's side by side, but it doesn't bother me enough. But the lighter weight and more portable nature of the Air versus the Pro and the nicer keyboard, which you type a lot on a laptop and it's a lot nicer to type on this. And because it can handle a lot of my workflows, I'm gonna keep the M4 MacBook Air and trade in the M3 Pro MacBook Pro. So that's been my experience over the past week, but let me know down in the comments if you have any questions or if you've been comparing it to your own MacBook Pros or MacBook Airs. Let me know what you think. Also get subscribed to the channel and hit that like button. I have that accessory video coming soon. And also, I'm gonna have a video coming soon about my favorite Mac apps, both ones that are new and updated, and the first ones that I install on the MacBook Air. I'll also put 2 videos up here that YouTube thinks you'll like, and I'll put a previous MacBook app video roundup right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.